I'm Darren Franich, staff writer for Entertainment Weekly and writer of the weekly column Entertainment Geekly.
And I am Zachary Levi, owner and operator of the Nerd Machine and Nerd HQ.
And this is Geek vs. Nerd. We're competing for the all-important Silver Trooper, aka the Strooper. Are you ready, Zach?
I am born ready.
We have 10 categories of questions. First category, Zach, comic book characters.
Hit me.
On what famous old Hollywood film star was Fandral the Dashing based?
Errol Flynn.
That is correct.
Ding, ding, ding!
That's one for you.
So now I'm throwing to you now, right?
There you go.
When did Deadpool make his first comic book appearance?
What year or what issue?
Issue and year for a bonus point.
I don't know the issue, but I think it was in X-Force. I'm gonna go with 1989.
Wrong on both accounts.
No! Was it New Mutants in 1990?
It was New Mutants number 98 in the year 1991.
Oh, dang.
Very close, though. Very close.
Our second category is toys / action figures. Arguably the same thing. When the Masters of the Universe line of toys debuted in 1982, Mattel was quickly sued by a company claiming that He-Man was a ripoff of another famous character.
Oh, my gosh.
Who was that character?
Conan the Barbarian?
That is correct. That is two in the bank.
I'm a genius.
That is two in the bank right there.
Oh,
Mattel
God.
Ultimately won the lawsuit, fun fact, but yeah.
I do remember that my sisters had She-Ra dolls and I had a He-Man doll, and He-Man had a lot of dates. All right, moving on to your question, toys, action figures. Transformers had a competitor early on that had their own cartoon and toys, although I feel like we've already stumbled here because...
It happened accidentally, but I did see the answer to this question beforehand. It wasn't like an NSA
situation. But you also
admitted
that...
I would have not gotten this correct.
There you go. And the answer, the GoBots, everybody.
GoBots. Who even had GoBots?
Dude, GoBots were badass.
Come on.
They were die-cast.
Name one
they were,
GoBot.
They were, all right, I started.
Stormtrooper, Stormtrooper.
Oh, dude, he is so out of your grasp right now. He's so out of you. This is not the trooper you're looking for. On Lost, what was the first animal to be seen donning a Dharma Initiative logo?
That would be the shark in the premiere of season 2.
Yes!
Yes!
Well done,
all
man.
All right.
How about that for a little TiVo Rewind? That was like a whoop whoop.
That was basically when we discovered TiVo Rewind. Now, John Locke, of course, named after a famous philosopher.
Mm.
When John Locke returned from the island, spoiler alert, in season 5, or whenever it actually happened, it was all around the place, he used a pseudonym, which is also the name of a famous philosopher, well, as famous as philosophers get. What was John Locke's pseudonym when he came back from the island?
I got nothing. I can't remember.
It was Jeremy Bentham, father of utilitarianism.
Oh my
gosh. I know, very exciting.
Oh my gosh.
Very exciting.
Next category.
All right, this category, Joss Whedon,
mm-hmm.
well-known fellow around these parts.
Mm-hmm.
Which Joss Whedon TV show does this scary rhyme come from?
Mm.
2x2, Hands of Blue, 2x2, Hands of Blue. Which Joss Whedon TV show?
I mean, I feel like the obvious would be to say Buffy. So I'm gonna stick with Buffy, actually. I'm gonna say that.
You're going with Buffy?
I'm gonna go. Don't look on your face. I lost. I lost. It's not Buffy.
It's so close. It's Firefly. It's what?
Oh my God, I should've.
Summer Glau.
Oh,
she keeps repeating it because
yes,
remember, like,
yes,
there's this weird, not
yes,
really explained guy.
No,
with the blue hand.
As you may know, I do an event during San Diego Comic Con called Nerd HQ. At Nerd HQ, there are many things that are offered to our guests. What would Joss Whedon most likely be doing at a Nerd HQ party? A, having a drink. B, having a conversation, or C, having a dance-off?
I'm gonna go with, you know what? I'm gonna be bold here. I'm gonna go with C, dance-off.
That is correct, sir!
Yes!
Joss Whedon will cut a rug in any way, shape, or form. The next category is Muppets.
Heard of them?
Heard of them. Name one or more live-action films that are highlighted in the Muppet Babies opening credits.
Boy, this is a total blind spot for me. This is gonna be...
You are 5 years younger than me,
yes.
So this might have been before your time.
I'm gonna say it was... Back to the Future? No. Two?
No.
Three?
No.
Part four?
No.
What was it? What were the films?
Two you could pick from Star Wars. Another one, Ghostbusters.
Track.
And Raiders of the Lost Ark.
So, oh. You know.
And completely not within the geek or nerd worlds. Done.
Serious question. What happens in the Dark Crystal?
Okay, so basically what happened was...
And forgive me because I'm a little...
And they did that. That's actually what happened.
Now, we would have accepted anything, because that movie is very confusing. Although, frankly, now
that
I think I understand
it. Is what
bit
happened.
More. TV theme songs.
Yep.
They used to have them back in the day. The classic 1960s Batman series. How many times did they say Batman in the TV theme song for Adam West's Batman?
Four.
You're going with four. So you're going with na na na.
So low.
You're going with na 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 Batman. Only four times? It's actually 11 times.
11! Turn it up to 11, folks.
11 times. They also say da, as in da 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 da.
Yeah.
15 times.
Yeah. On Seinfeld, George Costanza spoofs a television theme song for his answering machine's outgoing message. What show was this theme song from?
Three's Company?
No!
Oh, God, this is embarrassing. What TV show?
Greatest American Hero. Greatest American Hero! I start this next category. Proud to. Star Wars. Here we go. What was the pilot's call sign who discovered Han and Luke on Hoth after they had disappeared from Echo Base?
Was it Red One? Rogue One?
Nah!
Rogue Two.
Rogue Two.
I think it was Wedge, though.
Echo Base, this is Rogue Two. Bring it.
For you, sir.
Probably get it wrong.
What was the title of the first official Star Wars tie-in novel? It came out very early in the Star Wars era. Talk it out. What Star Wars novels do you know of?
Star Wars Fellowship of the Ring.
That's close.
I don't know. I have no idea.
That is very close. It was actually Splinter of the Mind's Eye.
Oh.
It's a very strange book, actually. They weren't sure that they were going to get Harrison Ford back for the next movie. So Han Solo, not in the book. Last category, Game of Thrones. Which of these families has not and has never been one of the great houses of Westeros? Lannister, Baratheon, Frey, Stark, Tyrell, or Greyjoy?
I'm gonna say Frey.
That is correct.
Oh! Oh my God! In the TV version of The Red Wedding, two people were killed who were not killed in the book version of the same scene. Name those two people.
Okay, well, one was Rob's wife. Are we counting Rob's unborn child as a person? Third person is in the book. Remember when Caitlin has like her knife to the we were just spoiling everything here. They changed it to his young wife.
Interesting.
So three of those people.
Interesting. Okay, well, you did overdeliver, and you were right on all counts, because I was just going with Rob's wife and unborn child.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
Sir,
boom.
Well done.
Yes. Here's the river.
Do we have a final count? Shut up! No, we didn't tie.
What?
No, we didn't tie. Did we really tie?
Oh no!
That is fate telling us that this is not claimed yet.
Sure.
And we need to have a rematch at some point in the near future to see who actually claims the Strooper.
Zachary Leva, you are a gentleman and a scholar and a nerd and a geek as well.
Thank you.
Well done.